Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask you to please stand, remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Perryville High School. PVTV 985 ready to bring you a great game tonight. District, this team will be in the Perryville District, so Class 4 District 1 matchup, folks. Before the players get out on the field, I will say next home game. Let us all come out here to Pirate Stadium, wear your green and white, blue and gold, as it will be a St. Vincent Perryville game. That is true. Last time they played was back in the 1930s.
The knob at the top of the parazoom. Can you twist it for me?
I'm Lane Kane for PVTV Sports, by the way. So Perryville cheerleaders, new look, new season, new look, different coaches. Cheering team leaded by sophomore Kelsey Bells on Annalise. Prayer. Hacklin.
Remember, we are D32. For tonight's contest, we'd like to welcome our guest, the Desoto Dragon.
Gurler, Alana, greeting, Abby Hook, Mae Keeker, Isabel Lake, Caitlin Manley, Sierra McAllister, Jill Morris, Megan Runge, Katie Schumer, Katie Parker, Phoebe Pullman, and Brittany Young. Coaches Erica Stevenson.
Connor 70, Connor 7. number 62, Kendall Barber. At offensive line, number 55, Wayne Young. At offensive line, number 54, Jesse Yates. At offensive line, number 53, Clayton Young. At running back, number 29, Derek Kearns. At wide receiver, number 18, Garrett Hicks. At wide receiver, number 13, Marcus Mahata. At wide receiver, number 11, Logan Paxton. At offensive back, number 10, Bryce Flaherty. And at quarterback, number 6, Ross Hodler. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your Perryville.
And folks, just in case you want to know why I'm not now announcing Desoto's starters, and we'll get to the Perryville coaches here in a minute. As I was saying, Desoto doesn't have their roster for us tonight, so hope you like listening to Mike announce just Perryville tonight. So Perryville offensive coordinator is Coach Ames, like Ames, Iowa. And defensive coordinator for Perryville is head coach Mike Wojcik. Folks, don't forget, I know this is now first season of first week one of football. But hey, October 1st is a big volleyball tournament. 20 teams coming to town, and you know, with Emo's Pizza now coming into Perryville and all the other new features that Perryville's going to get, might be a good time to come out and support your volleyball teams. So now that I have Perryville's lineup, the head coach is Mike Wojcik. His assistant coach is, like I already mentioned, John Ames, Garrett Ditch, Rick Dunn, Brent Brooking, Raymond WOLDTVEDT, Wayne Sheets, Thomas Johnson, Jemai MOLLETTE, and Gabe Krieger. And folks, with the timekeeper hanging down, looks like there might be some new rules tonight in football. So we'll keep you posted if we hear them. I wonder if they're going to have, you know, the time clock like Major League Baseball has, where the Chicago Cubs pitching coach decides to walk out on the field and takes 30 seconds to get up there and back. So Speaking of the Cubs, Cardinals are tied up 1-1 last I heard. We'll check it here. So currently top of the third, Cardinals are tied up with the Philadelphia Phillies 1-1. As you just heard, Mr. Wortman, principal at New Holcomb High School now, New Holcomb in Cape County Elementary School. Used to be the elementary school principal here in Perryville. Now at New Holcomb. So if you're curious to where New Holcomb is, it's on Highway 177. And just outside of Cape, near the R.E.O. Jackson area. So. Captains for the Perryville Pirates tonight are going to be number 54, Jesse Yates. Number 46, Lucas Ponder. Number 7, Brendan Renaud, who is out for a few weeks. And number 18, Garrett Dix. So both teams have pretty much brand new coaching staff. So we'll just see how well we do. So, you know, I got to say, it's pretty neat to play a team that's in the same color as you guys, as us, like St. John and here Desoto. Because no matter what, as long as you wear green and white, I guess you're okay. I mean, whatever colors you want to wear. So we'll hope to see what Mr. Cook and the studio can put out tonight to let y'all see a good football game. Oh, that's good. Mike's always shaking hands with the ref. One of the officials, excuse me. As the referee's in the middle talking with the boys. So Justin Dreyer, by the way, is on the clock tonight. You have Coach Broken and Wayne Sheets. All right, 2 minutes till 7 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen, as we are getting ready to kick this ball game off. So the Pirates have won the toss, and guess what? They will be playing offense first. Their special teams better get ready, as I'm going to guess it'll be Dix. Aaron Mueller not playing finally, as he's playing with the awesome two-time state champion Perryville soccer program. I must say state champion two in a row because, well, I'm not going to explain what happened at the state game for those who were there. We'll let you understand how Perryville should have been 2-0 state champions. So, by the way, state champions for soccer will be back up in Fenton again, even though the school schedule says it'll be here at the soccer field over by Bank of Missouri and Walgreens. We are downtown here at Pirate Stadium. Good luck to both teams tonight, Perryville and Desoto. 20 miles up north, St. Vincent is at Valley Catholic. Dexter's at St. John. A lot of other local schools playing each other. a team from Columbia playing Jackson tonight. So we know they had a long trip, so we wanted to see Hickman up there. A lot of the coaches are already saying, hey, you know, we want to see overtime already. So let's hope we don't see that well. It's probably going to be a delay game here because the Mr. Clock Operator, Justin Dreyer, is not here yet. Okay, he is to his spot. No 5-yard penalty, and the ball waited too long, so here we go. Desoto's number 18 looks to be kicking it off. Back deep for the Pirates, number 10, and nobody else. Bryce Flaherty, a sophomore, a junior slot back. Here comes the kick. Here we go from the 35-yard line, from the 40-yard line. Good booming kick. It's going to drop to number 10, Flaherty. He's going to take it from the 20. He's going to get a look. He's going to take off almost to about the 45-yard line. First down, Perryville with good field position to start tonight's ball game. So now let's see how Perryville's offense can go. I got my scoreboard here now, too. Hadler going to be quarterback. Motion, he gets the ball. He's going to run. He's going to look. He's going to be tackled for a loss, to for a 5-yard loss. Ball's going to be back at the 4-yard line. So it's going to be about second down and 15. Exactly, second down and 15. I'm right on the ball tonight. Big crowd coming in. Pepper Alley up there. I mean, tailgate party, hot dogs, hamburgers, chips, and of course, water sponsored by Perryville High School and Rich Thomas, the principal. Come out to next game and get early. Fumble, but he's going to throw and he's open. First down, Perryville. And I'm going to guess around the 20-yard line of Desoto's 20-yard line. I'm going to be waiting for official update. So the 26-yard line. So first down, I have a feeling we are just moments away from getting 6 points, ladies and gentlemen. I might be wrong, but I kind of have a little feeling. Hadler with the motion. He sets. He gives it off to number 29. He's going to go. He's going to go. Touchdown, Perryville. I was right with the feeling. And my scoreboard technology is working great. First play. So number 29, Derek Kern, for a touchdown. That'll be a 26-yard touchdown run. So let's see who's going to go in to kick. Looks to be number 10, and they're throwing the ball like, hey, we won our ball. Sorry, excuse me, Garrett Dix. His older brother was Grant, played for the Pirates also. Kick up, and I'm going to say good. So, I have a feeling that we're going to score more than just this one. So, folks, what do you say? Let's do that again. That was a good drive, you know. Only 1 second down in the game. Not even a third down. Not even, you know, we can't a football. You can kick on a third down. And here in America, you kick on fourth down. But we didn't even have to go to a third down. That was a great game. You know, great offensive drive. So Dix is going to kick off. Let's see if Pirate defense now can play some defense. Kick is going to be number 19. No, he's going to muck drop it. He's going to be tackled pretty good back there. He's going to be about the 12-yard line. I'm going to give an idea about the 12 or 13. So apparently Mike has some defensive information that I don't know. Okay, so Desoto is up. Free play here for the Dragons. So bring up 5-yard penalty on Perryville. So I was right at the 12. We're going to now start at 17. We're going to see if we have any other scores currently on the scoreboard for you. I see none yet, so I think we're the first team to score in this high school football season. He is going. Harryville's going to try again, but I think unless there's a penalty. Touchdown, Dragons. So, folks, several years ago, I think actually the last time we played DeSoto, we actually had a game that was pretty competitive against the Potosi Trojans here at home. I believe that was back in maybe 2012. It was like 43-43, and it was back and forth, bow, 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 bow. DeSoto went for 2 points conversion. Did they get it? Yes. So DeSoto. DeSoto currently now in the lead by 1 point. As Perryville's going to say number 40. Before he was going like, oh, great. What did I do now, coach? Number 18. Hey. You guys, we need somebody back there. Hey, where are you at? Never mind. I'm looking at the other end, and I don't see nobody. But I see that DeSoto didn't want to come out. 10:19 left in the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Don't forget you can follow us on YouTube and Facebook, PVTV 985 Digital Media on YouTube, and PVTV 985 on Facebook. Like us on Facebook, watch our games, watch the St. Vincent Perryville game over and over and over. Tell us what you think about it. See what we can do to improve. On side kick here, and he so says they have it. So Perryville will have the ball. Short field, at least. So this is going to start out where 5 yards, well, 5 yards better. Sorry, 5 yards shorter. 5 yards away from where the ball was to start the first drive. So I kind of have a feeling we're probably going to get back to the end zone pretty shortly, folks. Number 11 with the catch. Logan Thaxton, his brother, Kyle Thaxton, I believe, also played for Perryville. So there's so many players out here that had a brother that played, like Ross Hadler, Dix, a lot of others. Number 10 with the ball. And we're going to be at about the third 47. Okay. It's going to be bringing out third down and two. Need to get the ball to the 49-yard line, ladies and gentlemen. We do not have no more scores yet here. We'll check here on the PVTV scoreboard. So we have a lot of schools. We have like Fredericktown at Kent. And by the way, catching up on that play, it's going to be loss of a few. Perryville will be punting, I'm guessing. I believe that's going to be against Perryville. As well, I don't hear Coach Bosler yet banging on the wall on the left side of me, so I'm guessing we got more calmer coaching staff this season. Let's start at the 39-yarder. Lights are on here at the ballpark. Round of applause. Hey, folks, you hear these ladies are saying make some noise. I think let's make some noise. What do you say, fans? Let's back the house against St. Vincent and make a lot of noise because the Indians are in town. The tribe is a-rolling and the Pirates are stumbling. I'm sorry. The Pirates are also rolling. Ball Ryan made by Batosi or DeSoto. Second seven for DeSoto. Well, now it's going to be second and two. Hey, defense, you're supposed to be pushing the ball back, not pulling it forward. They're going to be number four, I believe, for DeSoto. We're going to be second down at about the 40s. There is a flag on the play, though. Looks to be in among with Perryville, so. So face mask on number 55, Perryville. It's done. They said Wade Young, so senior. Fumble flag on the play and well, DeSoto finally decided, you know what? We're going to, yeah. We got a few scores for you, so I'm going to, just going to go ahead and run these off. Wow. This is interesting. Festus has already won 29-26 at Vashon. No score, surprisingly, currently, with the St. Vincent Valley Catholic game. It's Kent 7. Fredericton 0 in the first quarter. Bring up second down. Central 8, Sullivan 0. So currently we're sitting, at least starting Class 4 District 1 in the rankings. Trip up play, but third down, it's going to be. I see Brian Dreyer over there on the chain gain. I don't know who the other two men are. On the chain crew. Well, we played 20 minutes and we're still 5 minutes into this ball game. Defense is looking pretty good. And there, oh yeah, Desoto will be punting, ladies and gentlemen, our first field goal. Sack. Player down number 440, so we'll be calling in assistant. Owensville is beating Potosi 7-6, Farmington 7-0. So don't know have anything yet on the Valley St. Vincent game, St. Vincent Valley Catholic Warriors. It's number four is already. That Jackson's gonna take off. He's gonna keep him going down to about the 30-yard line on DeSoto's. I'm gonna guess about. They're getting too far away that I can't even hardly see them. I have a feeling we're going to be seeing a lot of Perryville highlights on Channel 12 this here in these upcoming weeks. In the backfield now to run is going to be number 34, senior Kyle Creason. Hadler. Russell. It's going to be short. Lost a few yards. Roscoe Moldenhauer. So it would have been a touch about it's. Hey, Pirates, if you want to hold them, hold their hands after the game. Hadler, what do you think about that? Hold their hands after the game if you guys want to go ahead and hold them. Maybe the, one of the new rules in high school football is not running the play clock. Nope. Maybe there's a new rule that you got to score in 2 minutes or less of having the ball. So. Creason is going to try and get closer. Creason picks up a lot of gain. Gonna bring up a third down and 11. In field goal range, just about. First down, Perryville, I'm guessing. Oh, yeah, first down, Pirates. Ahoy, mateys. The ship is sailing and so are we. Ball gonna be placed at the 15-yard line. Hey, fans, let's turn up the volume. What are y'all saying? I'm hearing people back here in the booth asking for it. So Creason with a short run. We are 3 yards to go from the first down. Ball at the 8-yard line, ladies and gentlemen. 8 yards from getting into the DeSoto's end zone. I'm going to give, I guess, first down and goal again, ladies and gentlemen. Officials right there. First down and goal, ladies and gentlemen, from the 5-yard line. Come on, Pirates. We'd like to get 2 scores here before the first quarter is over. Ball at the 1-yard line. Second and goal from the 1. Is Perryville going to try to sneak in here? Touchdown, Perryville Pirates!
Thank you. Yeah, he's there.
So Perryville gonna kick it off, folks, and we're 44 seconds away. Tackle down there. Gonna be about the 25 yard line, excuse me. So Perryville's gonna push him back a little ways. So I'm going to bring up second down and 19. That's mostly 12 currently. At the end of the first quarter, Perryville 15, Desoto 8.
Come out to the fifth quarter at First Baptist Church of Perryville at 416 North Main Street.
Come out and hang out, shoot some pool, table tennis, have some hamburgers, cheeseburgers. Church band will be out in the parking lot after the game. Again, fifth quarter, hosted by First Baptist Church.
All right, folks, we are getting ready to start the second quarter. He's going to take off. Well, Valley Catholic 21, St. Vincent 0 in the first quarter. End of the first quarter, Kent 0, Fredericktown 0, Kent 13. Player down for Perryville, but he is up. So run made. Hey, folks, also the football team is doing amazing, too. I don't know what you guys think of, are thinking right now, but they look pretty amazing. So Deso's number 5 is, with the ball up. He was throwing it to a fan on the sideline. So that fan over there in the lime green shirt is not a player, Deso, even though he's in green. So second and 10. TikTok is ticking down. It's going to bring up third down now for DeSoto. Perryville, you are looking good. You want to see yourselves in the Super Bowl if you keep this up. So it's going to bring up third down and 10, and if the clock can run past here. Hurry up, clock, hurry up. Flag on the play, and so few people are applauding. I believe it's going to be a third down and 5. I want to go ahead and let everybody know here on the program, it says the assistant principal is Mr. Cook. That is a different Mr. Cook, besides the director of PVTV, who is way back in the studio somewhere around here. Maybe he's down there recording some highlights here for y'all. We have 10:01 on the clock. Somebody's asking for 10:01 on the clock. We have 10:01, so. So. Bring up a field goal attempt here for DeSoto. Ball's going to be at the 20-yard line. Do they go for it? If they go for it, folks, and they don't get it, it'll be Perryville's ball. And they are lined up to go for it. Pirate defense, what do you say? They're like, well, do we want to go? I bet they're gonna call timeout here. Yep. Timeout, Dragons. If you're yelling for the Pirates, say, go, Big Green. Go, Big Green. Big Green. Say, go, Big Green. Yell, go, Big Green. So here we go. Perryville will take over on downs. The guy on the chains is like Brian Ryder's like, hey, get down there. Let's see if we can put up another score before the end of the halftime. Hadler's going to be tackled back for a loss.
To your left. You're all the way to your left.
So how's everybody doing in Perryville, Missouri? And it's currently 80 degrees, but it feels a lot cooler. Intercepted by the Dragons, Trojans, whoever they are. Nathan Roos for Desoto. Give them a touchdown and they're 1 point away from tying this ball game up. Hey, I tell you what, I'm hearing them talking about the flag before. You'll get to see them perform at the Pirate Show here in about 25 minutes or so. Not looking at score clock, looking at normal clocks. So he says now, like, well, we got a 2-point conversion already. So now it's the extra point kick. No good. Pirates are still in the lead. All right, folks, we have the cheerleaders, and here we go, kicking off again. Run made by number 10 for the Perryville Pirates, Bryce. Flat. Flaherty. Slot back, defensive back, 5'9". 160-pound junior. So we'll see him next year. But, folks, I am just looking forward to the next, you know, 4 Fridays from now. Till the 49-yard line for the Perryville Pirates. Number 29, Garrett Kern. A junior also. He still has got the ball somehow.
Thank you.
I'm kind of thinking Desoto's chillers just got here. So good. Somebody's lagging here.
Yeah, I hear him. Hey, there goes Alex and Billy. Right?
Yeah, they're preparing ahead of time. Your brother's in there, man.
I know.
Flag on the play. Gonna be against Desoto. So if I'm Mike, I will decline it. Halftime, folks, is 7 minutes, 20 seconds away, according to game clock, but it'll be a lot longer. And the Desoto cheerleaders have finally arrived, so you will get to see them cheering. Well, at least their cheerleaders are here before the game is over. I think they have at least about 40 cheering members now. So, apparently Desoto is going to be going for an extra point or two-point conversion again.
Come on, Pirates!
Go, Pirates!
Folks, if you're looking at the scoreboard and you're wondering, who's home, who's away? If you're looking at the scoreboard, the visiting side of the field is the home side on the scoreboard. So the scoreboard, Desoto has 20. They're on the side that the Career Center is on. Perryville is on the side that the park is on. Now into the game, Garrett Richardy Jr.
Those cubes are coming off the field.
say run under them. You can get out of them and you can run outside. They're not crashing in, they're coming up the hill.
Picking for the Dragons, number 18, Joe Root.
Kick off. So saying it's their ball. I believe Perryville has it. Now, folks, I hate to say this. I really do. We have a score update still in the first quarter, 20 miles north, and the score is St. Vincent 0 and Valley Catholic 34. I hate to do that to you, but it's true. So for whoever plays Valley this season, get ready. That's a class and conference for St. Vincent. So Perryville's going to try to get in the little marking lines. A lot of fans here from Desoto, folks. Desoto, by the way, is in Jefferson County. So the clock is running when we have 6 minutes till halftime. 6 minutes till we can take a 15 minute break. Flag. So third down and 12 for Perryville. So we've already played 1 hour.
Did you walk here?
I walked.
Number 88, Tyler Yates was the receiver on the play, but caught it at the last second, and then it dropped out. Man, oh, man.
Now you're staying on that chair.
And by the way, folks, Cardinals are losing 3-1 at the end of the sixth. Hey, folks, first down, it looks. They're going to be throwing here and way too far. Hey, real quick, some good things that they got at concession stand down there to your left. They got good pizza. They got very good popcorn, very good salty buttery popcorn, $1 for a little baggie and like $2.50 for pizza. Have plenty of things to drink and keep you hydrated after a hot football night in downtown Pirate Country and Indian Country. And, of course, good cold water with hey, folks, I'm going to hang on after this play. Run made by Darush, number 18, Daru. So, you know, I'm going to say these tumbler cups actually keep get cooler than the Yetis. So, you know, I got mine at Walmart, pretty good deal. $9, but hey, they're well worth it than paying $32 at Walmart for a Yeti. So, you know, if you're going on a float trip or something down the Black River, that's a good river too. Hardly no current down there in the Lesterville area. You know, there might be pirates that might decide to actually try and meet you down there. They met us, so. Walk in the back, so Desoto Dragons will be backing up a little bit. They didn't put their beeper on. At least I didn't hear them backing up. Be a second down, 16. Pirates would like to hold them here and, you know, work the clock to get another touchdown. Perryville started to nudge a little. They're going to hold him for hardly no gain at all. Quarterback keeper for Desoto Dragons from Jefferson County, Missouri, in around the Festus area. Desoto is 21 miles from Festus on Highway 21, close to Hillsboro, about 8 miles from Hillsboro. Where the Hawks play tonight, they're playing Afton at home. I haven't seen any little score yet, but I haven't looked yet just yet for that one. Oh, drop the ball, so it's going to be a fourth down. Hey, kids, don't be rude up here. We got both principals here. We got Mr. Phillips and we got Mr. Cook. We got several others. Hey, we, Perryville football team, thanks you, number 7 for the Dragons, for giving us 4 extra yards. 4 yards less that we have to work to. Thank you, Desoto. We very appreciate you guys catching the ball right there. Four 14 left on the scoreboard, and it's been like 50 minutes ago that it was shown 8 minutes. So. Even though it feels pretty cool now, it's still 80 degrees now that, you know, the sun finally came up for a few days. And Creason's going to run a little. Mike's saying 5 yards, so I'm going to give it a 5-yard gain. Run made by Creason. So you want to know how Coach Dreyer runs the scoreboard? He listens to Wortman saying, second down and 5, and Dreyer's like, okay, well, we're going to put 5 yards in. So. Also listens to Mr. Curry over here to my right. The caller. Hadler is going to be hit. Hey, where did the sign go? It said so many downs. Oh, there it is. It left for a few seconds. It was looking for Mr. Cook, which is somewhere around here. Band is starting to twirl their flags. Halftime is approaching. So I would be thinking, would Perryville? Five-yard run by Creason, so. Here's the question. Dix has a pretty good leg. If I'm Perryville, I would maybe try to go farthest. And it'll be DeSoto's ball. About the 42-yard line. I've been requested from work to announce number 56, Dustin James. So there you go, babe. It's from your grandma, JoJo, at work. So. Hooks Valley Catholic, by the way, is winning 48-0. Good play there by Pirate D. Well, folks, you know, it's not over to the old lady sings, but I'm sorry, the big lady sings. But I'm thinking she's already probably singing at Valley Catholic for St. Vincent. Hate to say, because, well, St. Vincent is currently losing 48-0. Running clock already. So, folks, I want to explain to you, I know DeSoto only has one timeout, but they still have four remaining on their game. Perryville still has a total of five remaining. And, folks, we will be going to halftime with a score. Perryville 15, DeSoto 20. We will be away in the third quarter. At the half, your score, Perryville 15, DeSoto 20.
Perryville for your halftime entertainment is the Perryville High School Marching Buccaneers. The band is directed by Mr. Jerry Childers. Assistant director is Ms. Tiffany Whippenmeyer. Color guard director is Ms. Jessica Perez. Drum majors are Zoe Vernon and Jocelyn Bronze. Our show this evening is entitled A Pirate's Revenge. Drum major Zoe and Jocelyn, is the band ready? You may take the field.
Thank you. like to thank the parents and families that support their event throughout the season. The band will be participating in several band festivals and parades this year, and is proud to cheer on the PHS Pirates football team. Let's give another round of applause to our marching Buccaneers.
He lives near Park Avenue. Right here, see me? My hand. My hand.
Here.
Oh, yeah?
There's always time for
Well, folks, there you had it. Fat Lady's already sung with St. Vincent this morning. And we are a few seconds away from starting the third quarter. Can Perryville come back and pull it off and pull off a win? Can we go 1-0? Can we be undefeated? Everybody here in the booth is saying, yeah. Well, you can't really say that until after week three's over because just be. So for those who haven't heard, I hate to tell you this story, but it's Valley Catholic 64 and your St. Vincent Indians 0 at the half. St. Vincent will at least have 20 minutes to relax and probably get you a little bit of yelled at from their coaching staff. I'm just giving an idea. I mean, I remember doing that game last year, and, you know. Hey, if anybody can. Now, folks, don't give hope on St. Vincent because long, long time ago, my sister was a senior here at Perryville, and we were down 45-0 at the half, and we actually came back and won it in overtime, so. You never know what could happen, but I think Valley Catholic's got it already in the books. I know. You drink that whole water, but you were living, you'd be dead by now. Oh, put it this way. We at least know one of the Perryville schools will be not undefeated. I hate to say that, but I'm sorry, folks. Kick to DeSoto as number 8 Scott be tackled here. So now DeSoto's back out here. Here in a few minutes, we'll introduce the cheering lane team. Perryville's like, hey. Hey, folks, during the halftime break, I was talking to one of our Perry County deputies, the K-9 Deputy Davis, and talking about seeing if he can let the dog get out there on the field. And he said, you know, that dog would probably get roughness on the field. So never let your dog play on the football field with you. Incomplete pass for DeSoto. It's going to bring up third down and 12. Play on the field will be not enough, and it's going to be a Perryville Pirate ball pretty soon. So one of the Pirate flag ladies are now on the shift with one of the cameras. You would think, DeSoto. It's gonna be a pirate ball. Official timeout for a measurement here. All right, folks, so after the measurement, I was actually measuring with my Yeti cup, actually, First down with my large phone, according to a few friends of mine. I think my phone actually helped the Perryville Pirates with their first down. A lot of people say my phone's way too big. They can see it across the football field. So
I advise
And we have a little fan here in the game. Actually, a super little fan. It's a sweat bee. And we have a fan trying to fight with the sweat bee. And we have a player running with the ball. So, first down, Perryville Pirates. Yeah, it's annoying to see the player run the ball while you're trying to bat down the sweat bee back here in the booth. A win and it'll be a good night, like the song goes. I got a feeling tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good night. Here we go, here we go. I got a feeling tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's not gonna be a good night for St. Vincent. As they're, you know, last we heard 55 to 64 to nothing. Hey, you know what? Hey, whatever your name is back here in the booth, can you do that again so the Perryville Pirates can get another little bit of a run? So, So, Perryville is down by 5. Yeah, hey, officials, do you not, can you not see a play?
Hey, I believe you, buddy. Tim, good job. Yeah, on that. And then call the referees and tell them.
That comes into sports.
Watch the hole!
Actually, because of lifetime activity.
Folks out. We want to appreciate the folks out there in Trenton, Missouri. He'll be listening and watching next week's broadcast, next home game broadcast on YouTube and Facebook. And everybody in Alabama watching. We're going to have some friends down there playing college for Lawson State in North Central Missouri College up there in Trenton. Good luck to Lance Chapman as he's going to play for Trenton, and Noel Nyswanger as he's going to play for Lawson State. Good luck to both of those baseball players in their season, and we'll hopefully get to make a trip down to see them both. Small College World Series is where you would see them. There we go.
Robert right now.
We do not.
Yeah, babe. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Those girls are doing a great job, but I'm going to introduce you to their names as they're to the right of me. Kelsey Bezon, Annalise Freyer. Matt, M-A-K-A-I-L-Y, Gurler, Alana Greeting, Abby Hoke, Maddie Keeker, Isabel Lake, Caitlin Manley, Sierra McAllister, Jill Morris, Megan Runge, Katie Schumer, Katie Parker, Phoebe Pullman, Brittany Young. Hey folks, we just got another little insect crawling. I just killed a little bug here in the studio. Sorry to say that here on network, but he was bogging me, so actually I thought he just got back on. So, hey, you know what? I learned something last week, 2 weeks ago. Did you guys know lizards can grow their tails back? Perryville player down, and that's going to be number 11, Logan Thaxton. At Thaxton. So we'll take a second here, as that's actually Mahasa. Official word on Mahata is a cramp, according to the coaches to our left. All right, so I'm thinking, you know, wow, Chaffee's 33, Christmas City 13, Scott City 27, Grandview 8, Jefferson still, yeah, same thing. At the end of the first quarter, I have Valley Catholic 62, Kent 35, Fredericktown 10. Same quarter as our game. St. Jen 14, Dexter 0. Our County 21, Sickman, no, zip. There's a flag on the play. But a run made by Creasing. Heard one of the guys say that's on them. Not for sure where the head referee is. Okay, he's going to be holding on the Pirates. So Farmington and Fox out of the Arnold area is tied 13-13 in fourth. St. Pius and the ones are tied up in the third. Central 21, Sullivan 6 in the third. Chaffee 33, Crystal C 13 in the third. Grandview 8, Scott C 27 in the third. Valley's still in the first. Bring up third down 22. 5:24 left to play in the third quarter, according to Mr. Scoreboard. So it'd be neat to have a play that you got in the first quarter. You know, one of those do or die for a first down, like, Quarterback is down for Perryville. Who is going to come in if he has to leave? Drew Cronda would be your next quarterback if he can't make it, if he can't play out here. Good thing Perryville's got three quarterbacks. Approaching 9 o'clock here in Central Missouri. Here on PVTV 985. Hey, yeah. There is a foul flag. There is a flag on the play way back under 20. So I'm guessing Perryville probably had to re-kick it, perhaps. They're talking that it's against Desoto. The bugs continue to visit us here in the booth. Penalty is declined, and it will be Potosi's ball. DeSoto ball. Who's ever in the green, white tops, green pants. It's a ball.
Nathan, I have a favor to ask you.
Yeah?
Right now?
about me? So you gotta take care of the camera.
Alright, okay, now Eric's got it. Because I forgot Eric here. You just take care. Look at that. That's a new battery.
Pirate defense needs your help, boys and girls. Good job there by the Pirate defense. All right, Pirate defense, step it up here. Small crowd tonight, but let's pack the seats the next home game. My voice looks like, hey, defense, hey, see that play? Yeah. Do what's on my right side of my face, yeah. Mike was putting his hand on his face like, man, come on, you guys. All right, we got scoreboard coming up here updated. Fun ball. Hey, do you think they still can fumble it so we can get receive it, you know, grab it? So, boys and girls, like I mentioned earlier during the pregame, pretty much before this game started, don't forget the next home game is September 16th versus the team that's losing 64-0 currently. And that will be the St. Vincent Indians. Pass incomplete brings up third down and 10. So if you're Perryville, you know what you need to do. Gonna bring it up fourth down. So it'll be pirate ball. Shortly.
She's on her headset.
Don't tell me you're focused on me.
All right, hey, Cardinal fans, we got a little bit of a score for you. Our Cardinal game in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania is currently tied 3-3.
Good I was trying to see if I could trick you.
Causing confusion again.
No, I was trying to trick you into thinking that it was American. Yeah, but white moves is fresh.
We're checking the Olympics for you folks. We know that's a pretty good sport right now around here. So I'm checking it right now. It might have the Perryville Pirates in there. Get some run about an 8. Derek Kern on the run. Just going to bring up 2nd down and 3. Uh-oh, hey, K-9 is on his way. Folks, I'm innocent of being caught by the Sheriff K-9. That was Deputy Davis. He's on his way. Him and his rough friend is... United States has 105 gold medals, 105 medal count. First down, Perryville Pirates by number 34, Kyle Grayson. Cardinals and Phillies might be going to overtime, folks. Creasing trying to get away with the ball is creasing. We're going to bring up a 2nd and 7 with 50 seconds to play here in the third quarter. So the fourth quarter will decide who's going to win this ball game. Perryville, first down and several more yards. Okay. It's going to be a 3rd and 2, but apparently Coach Trier didn't hear our coaches too loud to me because they said 3rd down and 1. So. Hey, Pirate fans, let's get loud here. Fourth quarter is appearing. Perryville has it. First down, Perryville. So the ref was a little slow to say it, but after hearing Mr. Wortman and me say it to my right, he's like, you know what, we'll just give him the first down. How about that? We'll be friendly enough. Let's get fired up as... At the end of the third, Perryville 15, Desoto 20. We'll be back in a minute. All right, Pirate fans, are you ready? 12 minutes still remaining. Kern on the run. Yeah, we need one touchdown. Well, we only need a safety and a field goal. All right, come on, Pirates. Here on first down. Hey, Coach Dreyer, don't be running the score. Play clock until we're ready. Coach Dreyer is responsible for that call. Penalty. So they picked up pretty much right to where they left off. So it's going to bring up third down and four. Third down and manageable. Perryville would like to get some more points, ladies and gentlemen. We remember the Fredericktown that came down to it when Brendan Renaud got him a win. Hadler. You know, I gotta say, it's kind of getting a little late into this ball game. What do you think, Pirates? Fourth down and three. I'm gonna go for it, but you better hurry up so you don't get a 5-yard penalty. Hadler gets the set. He better hurry up with the ball. So it's going to be DeSoto's ball at the 40-yard line.
Come on, D!
All right, Pirates, I'm sorry about the call that I just made because that just cost us maybe some points. All right, so DeSoto's going to get it with good field position. And the way they've been tricking, I would wonder if Perryville would try to start guarding the wide receivers and be on them. Hey, our lucky charm is in the studio. The Fredericktown game, Coach Dreyer's little daughter came over and sat with her when we were down by a little, and guess what? She's back. So here we go, Pirates. We're going to win this now. Pirates guys are like, hey, guys, you know, hey, let's pick it up. Jesse Yates is like, hey, guys, come on. Make some noise. I'm Jesse Yates. Go, So is that going to bring up a second down? I'm curious. Yeah, second down and six. Pirates would like to push them back. You know, Brent Rocking over here to my left, he's like, okay, let's hear what play can we do. Yeah. Defense. Let's hear those fans out. Pause here. Folks, we're going to extra innings in Philadelphia, PA. They want all the Pirate fans to get home and watch Matt Adams maybe walk it off. Because I know Mike Wojcik is down here, so he's not going to get to Philly in time. Valley is still, by the way, winning 62-0. All right, Lena, you picked a wrong game to go to. That's Todd Richards with channel 12. Well, our lucky charm is now down there walking. Pirates, what do you say? We need some defense. We don't need them to get on their offense. We need our defense. All right. Time for the rally caps, I guess, if you guys are not going to be pushing them back. Okay, my rally cap is on, so. Hey. Hey guys, the clock continues to tick down. Hey folks, I hope our highlights are good enough to get on Channel 12. Time out, Desoto. Valley Catholic 68-0 in the fourth quarter. Kennett 49, Fredericktown 10. Farmington Fox are in first of so many of OTs. Windsor 40, St. Mias 26. Folks, Perryville, a touchdown and a two-point conversion away from being like Fred Farmington and Fox. So your favorite player, number 10, will be back deep for Perryville. Final, Scott C, 46, Grandview, 8. Robert, run made by somebody in playing chicken because he was going behind both players. We need a touchdown. Hey, we need anybody to pull out a touchdown out of their pocket. We need it. No, touchdown, 2-point conversion would tie it. Touchdown and field goal. A even 5 minutes to play. Well, Grandview will probably be coming through Perryville anytime now. All right. Hey, referees, I got to ask you, do you guys have any flags in your back pocket?
Hey, Tim, you're going to have to make sure next game that they have flags in their pocket before they run out here.
Just telling one of the best volleyball referees, Tim Steffens, to make sure that they have flags in their back pocket. And the band is trying to pump everybody out. As I think they are saying, right to fall. Ding, 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 ding. Right to fall. Perryville, guys, you don't have time to have another play. Package of plays in your back pocket. You know Perryville's going to go for this. They need somebody to catch a ball and run. First down, Perryville Pirates. Deep pass. Oh. Hey, folks, before we start the game, I was about ready to say rain in the forecast, but I don't see no rain, and I believe Channel 12 was saying it might rain and lightning and pause some games. So if you guys were wrong once again, Brian Ollsworth. And Laura. I'm not going to even say it. Pibbenmeyer, excuse me. With about 2 minutes and 45 seconds. Till we get our first loss. Too late to play. Pirates, hey guys, I don't know if you can tell, but you need an interception and a touchdown and a 2-point conversion with 2:08 to play. We can get our 2-point conversion on the expiring clock. Come on, Pirates! Farmington wins 26-20 in OT. We have several finals now. We have Scott C, 46, Grandview 8, Chaffee 39, Crystal C 19. Crystal C gets to head home now. Jefferson 20. Oh my goodness. Hey, folks. Valley Catholic's only 23 points away from 100 points. All right, folks, both Perryville schools currently are going to be 0-2. Hey, defense, here you go. Well, it's pretty much over now for the Pirates.
Huh?
They can't run the clock yet.
So at this time, Desoto's saying, hey, we're going to, you know, kneel it here. As the rally caps are not doing nothing, so. They do, they're going to be sorry. Flags. We want to thank all the 50 cheerleaders from Desoto making this trip down here finally, as that will do it. So I want to say again, myself, Lane Kane, and the rest of the crew, you guys have a great evening, and enjoy 3 away games for Perryville. St. Vincent will be at home next Friday with Scott C. Should be a much better football game for them. Valley is trying to get to at least 80. If not better. So the Desoto Dragons will go undefeated at home, on the road at Perryville here. So therefore, folks, if we would go to districts currently. Hey, folks, we got a, just got this. That will be your final. Desoto will take the win, 23-15. Well, folks, it's been a great game. You know, we couldn't score in the third or fourth quarter or in the second, but great game tonight. Heck, you know, the next home game is going to be September 16th against the St. Vincent Indians here at Pirate Park. So we'll be away with you. We'll be not here for 3 weeks. So we want you to come out, everybody that can, all the sea limits of Perryville, please come out. All right, that's a wrap. Good night.